keep on believing things will change for the better. If we keep on believing that the love.
So, Robin, thank you so much for coming down to our little couch area and coming on a chat. And that was a beautiful song. I've listened to a few of your tracks that you've got on your SoundCloud and you've got online and bits and bobs. It's very emotive, very gentle. Where do you get your inspiration from for such honest and raw music?
The honest answer is I haven't got a bloody clue.
Fair enough. Okay.
It's a mixture of music I'm influenced by and experience.
Okay, so you mentioned about music that influences you. Who are we looking at? What kind of music?
The Witch.
Okay.
No, I'm kidding. Sorry.
I was like, are we on the right show?
Absolutely love King's Convenience and Ralph McTell.
Right.
And the obvious numbers like Radiohead and the Beatles and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, the Tale Tellers.
I like to think it's somehow audible in the music without it being too much of a rip-off, like, you know, Tomorrow or whatever, you know.
Yeah, yeah, very, I know what you mean, like the sort of the innuendos and that. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, how did you get into music then? How did the process of writing for you start?
That's a very good question. I've grown up with music, really. Like my earliest memory is hearing the Seekers in the back of the car that my dad was playing.
On a day trip.
And they were playing that song Lemon Tree, and it was, I think that's the earliest song I can remember liking and independently thinking, I bloody love
that.
How did I get into writing? Good question. Well, very personal, but my old man passed away and I started writing about that initially.
Did you find it quite therapeutic and exercising your feelings and how you were going and the things you were going through at the time through music?
I personally did, but I'm not sure about those who had to hear it.
Yeah.
I think for them it was a traumatic experience. So I was terrible back then.
Yeah.
Terrible.
How old were you at the time?
About 17.
Gosh, yeah, so it could have been a whole different range of noise.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're self-taught. Are you self-taught or did you have lessons?
I did have lessons.
Right.
But I wasn't a very good student because I just couldn't understand theory.
Okay.
So he eventually taught me how to teach myself.
Oh, fantastic. So, so from 17 years then you've just been strumming away, writing material and developing as you've gone along.
Yes.
I mentioned before that your material does seem quite gentle. And quite emotive. Are you anxious when you're performing music that's quite personal, I guess? Do you feel like you're offering like a main vein on stage and going, please like this because this is really personal?
Nah,
are you able
not
to
really.
Detach from that?
Yeah, very much so. If it's quite raw or whatever, I just won't play it.
Okay.
Because if it's raw for me, that's very selfish. And really, if I'm doing something that's emotive, I want the audience to feel it.
Yeah.
And for me to not feel it. I've felt it already, so
You don't want to go there again.
Yeah. Well, not so much not wanting to go there again, but it's more, if I'm feeling it when I'm performing it, it's a bit selfish, really. It's not really what it's for. It's not what performance is about, really.
Okay.
It's about making other people feel what you once felt.
That connection.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you sticking within that sort of, that vibe of music, or is there any times when you just want to rock out, get really angry and throw out some...
Maybe musically the same vibe, but lyrically maybe not. I'm kind of moving towards more... I think satire is a very grandest term to put it. I'd put it more just taking the piss out of things I don't like.
Okay.
Which is, I'm doing an EP all about that kind of
fantastic.
Writing. And then I'm going to finish it off with that Keep On Believing, which I've just played.
Yeah.
But we need some hope at the end of something like that, really.
Yes. So what can we expect in the EP in terms of style of music and also the lyrical content? Is it going to take us on a journey, or is it very much
I'm specifically making lyrical content. None of it's from my perspective. It's all from the perspective of people I'm mocking, whether it be the Prime Minister or belligerent managers.
You've got lots and lots of material to work there.
So it's going to be a bit from their perspective, but obviously my take from their perspective, which is kind of probably not really how I see things at all.
Okay.
But we'll see what happens.
So is that where you draw your material from, and just everyday occurrences that you make a mental note and then go away and develop something from that, or is it?
I'm not sure if I make a mental note as such. Maybe I do, but I'm not one of those notebook kind of people.
Okay.
These days I find it hard to write anything at all, if I'm honest.
Right.
It's like getting blood out of a stone.
Okay.
But it's probably a good thing as well, because it means I've got less to inflict upon the general population.
Sure. Yeah. So were your family growing up, and you mentioned your family and music in the car, and were your family quite musical as a group?
Yeah, my uncle specifically was. He was, he still is. He was a fiddle player and banjo player back in his 60s,
wow.
And just kind of rubbed shoulders with the folkies of that time.
Are you going to name drop? Okay, like that with our imagination. Okay, so as a family then, was it encouraged? Was music encouraged as a child growing up?
It was. I mean, I had piano lessons as a kid.
Right.
And hated them, so I didn't do any further. I didn't get beyond playing Three Blind Mice. And I can't say I'm beyond that standard now. Really.
And that's where you're up to now. So we've got you on the grand piano upstairs. Yeah. Three Blind Mice. That's where you're up to. Okay.
Yeah.
So moving forward then for you and the EP, are you gonna record that yourself? Are you gonna do that? Are you hoping to get in the studio and do that? Are you gonna produce it yourself?
I'm hoping to get into a studio.
Okay.
And record. I want to keep it as acoustic as possible, but it won't just be one guitar and one voice, because
right.
That's how I play it live. I'm going to add a few more backing vocals, this, that, the other.
Okay.
Just to kind of spice it up a bit, really.
And give it a bit of a fullness and a bit of depth
yeah.
in the studio. Are you, is that something you're going to have to self-fund through?
Yes.
It's a nightmare.
I have a job.
You have a real job in real life. Mm. Just going off kilter completely, going back again, can you remember what was the first piece of vinyl, first piece of music you bought? That you actually remember physically going out going, I like that, I want to buy that. Now, you've not got time to think of cool answers here. It's almost a straight honest answer. What was the first piece that you bought?
I think the first single I ever bought was probably Some Might Say.
Gosh, okay.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it was exciting.
Yeah.
It was at a time when it was all about grunge and Nirvana, and they were great.
I was there.
The Oasis lot came along.
I
didn't know much about them at the time, and just saw this thing on Top of the Pops, and just thought, I'm buying that tomorrow.
I love that, thank you
and
very
much. I went and bought a cassette.
Did you?
I did.
Did you have a little cassette player as well?
Yes.
Okay. Are you going to embrace the digital age then with your release, with your EP? Are you going to make, because obviously you've got a SoundCloud presence, I'm assuming you're on...
Well, this is the thing.
Okay.
This time last year, I was still walking around with a CD Walkman.
Get away.
Yep.
How very retro.
Well, it wasn't a retro thing, it was a laziness thing. I've had this thing since 1997.
Wow, you've got the money's worth out of that.
Oh, completely.
Yeah.
But, yes, I will be engaging in the digital world,
okay.
Whatever that might be.
Yeah, so are you going to... Do you think it's important to make your music available online? Is that something
that you think? I think it is, yeah, because most people these days, downloading is the norm, isn't it? It's thoughtless.
Yeah.
I like vinyl simply because I love the experience and I love the storage issues. I just obviously.
Did you make any purchases on Record Store Day recently? It was like carnage in town. Did you go in and make any
purchases? I didn't know. It's all about 50p in the charity shops for me.
Oh, there's some crackers in there,
yeah,
aren't there?
Completely.
There's some absolute crackers. So, final question then, Robin. If you could work with anybody, either past, present, if you could work with any musician.
Ralph McSell.
Straight away.
Yeah.
Okay. Why? Why Ralph?
Because he's amazing. He's an absolutely phenomenal guitar player, and he's a complete wordsmith. He's 71 maybe.
Is he really that old?
He is that old, and he looks about 50. So I don't know the secret. And he's
great moisturizer.
I've been to see him about 13 times now.
Wow.
And he's a beautiful man, and his voice is like therapy, and his lyrics are something else. He takes you somewhere else, and the way he plays that thing is remarkable.
He would be your ultimate.
Completely.
Yeah. Mm. Okay. Brilliant. Robin, I'm really excited to see what happens with the EP, and interesting to see who you sideswipe at in the process of the EP. do keep us informed. It's been lovely having you down on Summit.
It's been lovely to be
thank
here.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.
All right, my love. Good luck. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.